I am Prashant Vishwanath Dhanshetti, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today I am here to explain you about the influence line diagram for a shear force at a given section of a girder. The learning outcome of today's lecture is students will be able to study the effect of moving load on shear force of structural member. They will be able to construct influence line for shear force, and they can calculate the shear force for the system of loads. Influence line diagram for shear force function. So it is a curve or a graph that represents a function like the shear force at a section of a structure for various position of unit load on the span of the structure is called influence line diagram for that given function. Influence lines are very important in the design of structures subjected to a greater live loads. With influence line, it is easy to determine the location of the live load which will cause greatest influence on the structure for a given function. Moving or live load. Moving load are the loads applied to a structure with the points of application, including their magnitude, can vary as a function of position on the structure. Including their magnitude means the magnitude of the moving loads are also variable. Shear force at a given section using ILD for the moving loads. Can you define a shear force? Here, pause the video and try to write answer on a paper. Shear force, it is the algebraic sum of vertical forces at any section of a beam to the right or left of the section is known as shear force. It is also called as unbalanced vertical force. Shear force diagram is one which shows variation of shear force along the length of the beam. Static shear force diagram. So static shear force, how we define? So here beam is there and a point load is applied here. So to draw a static shear force, so we have to consider the sign convention. Though the left of the section upward will be positive and right of the section downward will be positive. So now here I have taken the reactions here WB by L and WA by L. So when I consider a shear force on the left of this section W, so I will get this only one force, that is reaction, and that is upward, means it is positive in nature. So I have drawn here WB by L and it is constant up to this point load. And when I have to consider the shear force at this side, so I am considering the right side of the section. So only one force is there, that is reaction, that is WA by L. So it is upward, but our sign convention is right of the section downward is positive. Here upward means I have to show it negative. So I am drawing here in the lower side. So WA by L, and it is constant up to this point load. When I join this, I will get a shear force diagram. This shear force diagram is for static loading condition. Now shear force diagram at a section for a moving unit load. So when a unit load moves from A to B, what will be the shear force diagram? Let a unit load moves from the span A to B and D be the section where we have to find out the shear force. Now this AD portion is having a length A and DB portion is having a length B. When the unit load is between A and D, now here the unit load is between A and D. So here may be the unit load. The shear force at D section. So shear force at D section, what it will be? So I will consider the right side of the section. So right side of the section only I am having one reaction, that is upward reaction. But right side of the section, so downward is positive, upward is negative. So it is VB reaction. So I am drawing this reaction downwards. So we know that VB varies from 0 to 1 as the load moves from A to B. So this I have explained the how to find out the influence line diagram for the reaction in the previous video. So kindly watch that previous video for the reaction of ILD. Now, so I have drawn here 0 to 1 in the negative side. So as long as the unit load is between A and D, so my shear force at D will be minus VB. Now, when the unit load comes beyond point D, when the unit load moves and it is between D and B section, now I will consider the shear force to the left of this section. So to the left of this section, I am having only one reaction, that is RA or VA. So shear force at D is plus VA, because now left of the section upward is positive. So here again, we know that VA varies from 0 to 1 as load moves from A to B. So as it is positive, I am drawing it upwards. So this will be the ILD for reaction VA. Now, this both the part of the influence line diagram between VB, A and D is negative, and the part of the influence line diagram for VA between D and B is positive. So here both will constitute the influence line diagram for the shear force at section D. Now here I am drawing the section. So this left side will constitute a negative and this right side will constitute the positive value for the shear force at this section D. Now we will determine a shear force at a section for a given system of load. So now the shear force is again can be found out by multiplying intensity of load into the ordinate of the influence line diagram corresponding to the position of the load. Now these are the load and I have to find out the shear force at this section D. So as explained earlier, so we have to draw this ILD for VB in the negative direction and VA for the in the positive direction. And here I am drawing a section line here. So at this point, so from this point D of onwards, it is having positive value and this is having a negative value. So now I have to take this corresponding ordinate for this load for the 7 kilonewton. What will be this ordinate? So I can easily find out this by using similarity triangle. So this will be 1 by 6 and this will be 5 by 12. So now I have to multiply this. Shear force at D will be 7 into this ordinate. So as it is in the negative portion, I will having a negative sign here, minus 1 by 6 plus 6 into this again negative ordinate, minus 5 by 12 plus 5 into this ordinate, it's positive, that is 5 into 1/3. So I will get the shear force at section D as minus 2 kilonewton. Now to determine the maximum positive shear force at a section D 4 meter from left end for a 2 wheel loads, any wheel load can lead the other. So here the 2 wheel loads are passing which are having a fixed distance 2 meter from the distance between them. So now what will be the position, so when you will get the maximum positive shear force? So for that I have constructed this ILD. So this ILD for VB is negative, ILD for VA is positive. So now observing this diagram, so what I understand is for that maximum positive shear force, I should have both the wheel loads on the this portion, that is in between D and B. So now the heavier load should be just right side of the point D, but for calculation we can take it exactly on the top of the point D. So now I have to take this ordinate and this ordinate. As both these are in the positive area, so this 20 into 3/4 plus 8 into 5/8, so it will give you 20 kilonewton positive shear force. Now to determine the maximum negative shear force at a section D for the same load case, that is having two wheel loads and at a distance of 4 meter from the left end. So what I have to do, again you observe this influence line diagram. So this portion is giving a negative value, this portion is giving a positive value. So for a maximum negative shear force, your wheel load should be in the portion AD, and the maximum or the heavier load should be exactly near the point D or just left of the point D. But for calculation, you have to take exactly at point D. So therefore, maximum negative shear force at D is 20 into this negative ordinate minus 1/4 plus 8 into this ordinate minus 1/8. So that will give you minus 6 kilonewton. Now to determine the shear force at a section D for a given system of load, that is UDL. So shear force, again here we can find it by multiplying intensity of load into area of influence line diagram between the UDL. So now here I have drawn the section. So this part will give you positive portion, this will be having negative portion. So again I will take this ordinate for the starting of UDL and end of UDL. So this shaded area will give you the area of influence line diagram multiplied by load intensity. So here again this is a trapezoidal, so area you can calculate by 1/2 sum of parallel side into height. So this will give you positive value, this will give negative value. So solving this I will get minus 0.57 kilonewton. Now for the positive shear force, what position should be there? Therefore, so seeing this ILD, so I should be placing the UDL on the right portion. So here again I am having the right portion. So this area into the intensity will give you positive shear force, that is plus 8.57 kilonewton. And for maximum negative for the same case, so I should place this UDL to the left of the section, as this gives the negative value. Into this area into intensity I will get the negative minus 5.14 kilonewton. These are my references. Thank you for watching my video.